Yes, good morning students. In the 7th group elements, we already discussed few topics, that is electronic configuration, oxidation state, interhalogen compound, oxy acids of chlorine and oxides of chlorine. These topic already discussed. Then today we discuss chemical reactivity. So this chemical reactivity are following types. In these following types, then first one, react with water. And second one, react with alkalis. And third one, react with hydrogen. And fourth one, react with metal. That means fluorine react to water, chlorine react to water, resultant seventh group element react to water. Simply, then first one, water. Here, fluorine react to water to give OF2 and O2F2. Here, 2 moles of fluorine react to 2 moles of water to get 4HF plus O2. The same time, 3 moles of F2 that react to 3 moles of water to get 6 moles of HF and O2. So this is water. That means fluorine react with water to get O2 and O3. These O2 and O3 are allotrope of oxygen. So now this is fluorine. The next one, chlorine. Here fluorine react to water to get O2 and O3. Here chlorine react to water to get HCl plus HOCl. That means chlorine react to water to get HCl and HOCl. That HOCl is thermally dissociate to get HCl plus a nascent oxygen. At the same time, for example, you take bromine Br2 plus H2O to get HBr plus HOBr. For example, I2 plus H2O to get HI plus HOI. So this is react with water. The next one, second one is react with alkalis. Here alkalis, the best example is NaOH. Which means chlorine react to NaOH. These are two types. Then first one, Cl2 react to 2 moles of NaOH to get NaCl. NaCl plus NaOCl plus H2O. Next, if concentrated condition, 3 moles of chlorine that react with 6 moles of NaOH to get 5 moles of NaCl, then NaClO3 plus 3H2O. This is alkalis. Here, in case if you take Br, here Br2 plus 2 NaOH, in this one, Br2 plus 2NaOH to get NaBr plus NaOBr plus H2. Now second one, in case you have 3 moles of Br2, that is 6 moles of NaOH to get NaBr, that means you have 5 moles of NaBr. Here NaBrO3 plus 3H2, this is alkalines. In case if you take I2, here I2 plus 2NaOH to get NaI plus NaOI plus H2. In case 3I2 plus 6NaOH, 5NaI plus NaBrO3 plus 3H2. So this is what is reacted to alkalines. Next one, third one, reacted to hydrogen. Reacted to hydrogen. A reactive to hydrogen means flow generally X2 plus H2 uses to 2HX. Simply H2 plus F2 uses to 2HF. The next one, H2 plus Cl2 uses to 2HCl. H2 plus Br2 uses to 2HBr. H2 plus I2 uses to 2HF. So this is reactive to hydrogen. H2 plus F2 uses to 2HF. This equation slow in dark condition. H2 plus Cl2 uses to 2HCl. This equation slow in dark, fast in sunlight. H2 plus Br2 uses to HBr. It is in the presence of at room temperature. H2 plus I2 uses to HI. This in the presence of catalyst. So this is react to hydrogen. Simply hydrogen react to halogen to get 2HX. Here fluorine react hydrogen to get 2HF. Chlorine react hydrogen to get hydrogen chloride, hydrogen bromide, hydrogen iodide. So fluorine is formed in the dark condition. Chlorine is formed in the form slow in dark and fast in sunlight. Bromine is in the presence of room temperature. And iodine is in the presence of catalyst. So this is chemical reactivity of water. Chemical reactor hydrogen. First water, fluorine react water to get O2 and O3. This is, one is dilute condition and second one is concentrated condition. Chlorine react water to get HCl and HOCl. That HOCl is thermally dissociate to get a necessary oxygen. If yes, necessary oxygen is there, that's why that compound is a good bleaching agent. The next one, alkalis. Chlorine react alkalis to get NaCl, NaOCl plus H2. This is in the dilute condition. If concentrated condition, chlorine react NaOH to get NaCl plus NaClO3 plus 3H2. The same way, Br2, I2, in all are same thing. The next one, hydrogen. Fluorine is formed in the dark condition. Chlorine is formed slow in dark and fast in sunlight. Bromine is formed in the presence of room temperature and iodine is formed in the presence of catalyst. So this is what is react to hydrogen. Fourth one, react to metal. React to metals. This react to metals means here 2 moles of sodium. 2 moles of sodium that react to I2 to get 2 moles of NaI. The same time here copper react to fluorine to get CuF2. Sodium react to iodine to get NaI. Copper react to fluorine to get CuF2. So these are called react to metals. These are called react method. These whole topic are called chemical reactivity. So this is chemical reactivity. After that chemical reactivity, now we discuss about chlorine topic. Now we discuss about chlorine. These chlorine are basically following types. Next one, chemistry of chlorine. Chemistry of chlorine. So this is in the chemistry of chlorine. This chlorine is a that means chlorine is naturally available in chloride. Chlorine is naturally available in chlorides. So what is the first chlorine preparation? These chlorine preparations are basically following types. That means here 4 moles of HCl that react to MnO2 to get MnCl2 plus H2O plus Cl. This is chlorine preparation. That means here how many hydrogen is there? 4 hydrogen is there. Here how many hydrogen? 2. That should get 2 moles of water. Here hydrochloric acid that react to manganese dioxide to get MnCl2 to H2O plus Cl. At the same time, here 4 HCl is there. Next one, 16 moles of HCl that react to 2 moles of KMnO4 potassium permanganate to get 2KCl plus 2MnCl2 plus 8H2O then 5Cl2. This is methods of preparation of chlorine. The next one, third one, this is the last preparation. 4HCl that react to O2 in the presence of CuCl2 to get 2H2O plus 2Cl2. This is methods of preparation of chlorine. These methods of preparation of chlorine are basically these 4-3 types. Then hydrochloric acid react to MnO2 to get chlorine is prepared. Then 60 moles of HCl react to potassium permanganate to get chlorine is prepared. Hydrochloric acid react to oxygen in the presence of CuCl2 to get chlorine. So this is chemistry of chlorine. That is methods of preparation of chlorine. This chlorine which can be prepared from 3 processes, that is from hydrochloric acid react to MnO2, hydrochloric acid react to KMnO4, hydrochloric acid react to O2. Hydrochloric acid react to MnO2 to get chlorine. Hydrochloric acid react to KMnO4 to get chlorine. Hydrochloric acid react to oxygen to get chlorine. This is methods of preparation of chlorine. The next one, chemical properties of chlorine. These chemical properties of chlorine are all like this. Then again react to water, again react to alkalis, again react to hydrogen, again react to metal. That is chemistry of chlorine. Now in this chemistry of chlorine, so here next one, chemical properties of chlorine. Chemical properties of chlorine. Next topic is chemical properties of chlorine. Chemical properties of chlorine. Chemical properties of chlorine. These chemical properties of chlorine are basically following types. In this one, first, now we have already discussed here a react to water. Then again we discuss following topic. Again react to water. Here what happened? Chlorine react to water to get HCl plus HOCl. Then again the H4Cl, is thermally dissociated to get HCl plus a nascent oxygen. That's why this H4Cl is a good bleaching agent. Next one, react to hydrogen. Just to discuss. H2 plus Cl2 in the presence of slow in dark and fast in sunlight to get 2 moles of HCl. Just to discuss. Here, where chlorine is there, that all are called core chlorine chemical properties. At the same time, now here very important equation. C10H18. This compound that reacts to 8 moles of chlorine. 8 moles of chlorine to get. What happened? In this one, C10H16. Now to get 10 moles of carbon plus 16 moles of HCl. So in this one, C10H16, that compound react to 8 moles of chlorine to get 10 moles of carbon plus 10 HCl. Third one, react to alkalize. That react to alkalize means anyway. Now what happened here? First, Cl2 plus 2 NaOH juice raised to. Here NaCl plus NaOCl plus H2. The next one, 3 moles of chlorine, 6 moles of NaOH to get 5 moles of NaCl plus NaClO3 plus 3H2. This is react to alkalize. After that react to alkalize, for example, this is react to alkalize. Next one, fourth one, react to metals. Here react to metal means, just now already discussed, here react to metal means 2 moles of sulfur. 2 moles of sulfur react to chlorine to get S2Cl. Next one, sodium. 2 moles of sodium that react to chlorine to get 2 moles of NaCl. So this is react to metal. The next one, after that react to metal, the next one, react to hydrocarbon. These react to hydrocarbons are basically following types. Saturated hydrocarbon. Saturated hydrocarbon. And second one is unsaturated hydrocarbon. Now let us discuss saturated hydrocarbon. This saturated hydrocarbon means saturated hydrocarbon, the best example is alkane. So alkane general formula is CnH2n+2. In this one, if n equal to 1, that is methane. CH4, methane, react to chlorine in the presence of sunlight. To get monochloromethane, simply CH3Cl plus HCl. Then again the monochloromethane, CH3Cl, that react to chlorine in the presence of sunlight to get dichloromethane, CH2Cl2 plus HCl. Then again the dichloromethane, CH2Cl2, react to chlorine in the presence of sunlight to get chloroform, CH2Cl3 plus HCl. Then again that chloroform, CH2Cl3, that react chlorine in the presence of sunlight to get carbon tetrachloride plus HCl. Simply, methane react chlorine to get monochloromethane, monochloromethane react chlorine to get dichloromethane, dichloromethane react chlorine to get trichloromethane, is nothing but chloroform, chloroform react chlorine to get carbon tetrachloride. These all equations are in the presence of sunlight. These all equations are in the presence of sunlight. Simply, these all equations, these whole equation which can. So here what about first one? CH4. Now how many chlorines? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 moles, 4 Cl2, uses to the last one carbon tetrachloride. Simply CCl4. CCl4 plus how many HCl? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 HCl. This is, that means here methane saturated hydrocarbon. Saturated hydrocarbon means carbon-carbon single bond. Saturated hydrocarbon means carbon-carbon single bond. Where carbon-carbon single bond is there, that are called saturated hydrocarbon. Saturated hydrocarbon, the best example is methane. When methane reacts chlorine to get monochloromethane, monochloromethane reacts chlorine to get dichloromethane, dichloromethane reacts chlorine to get trichloromethane, is nothing but chloroform. That chloroform reacts chlorine in the presence of sunlight to get carbon tetrachloride. Simply, the first compound, this whole four equation, we can write one single equation. That first compound, what happens? CH4. How many chlorines? 1, 2, 3, 4. Simply 4 Cl2. The last one is carbon tetrachloride. Carbon tetrachloride. Then how many HCl? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 moles of HCl. This is hydrocarbon. The next one, second one is unsaturated hydrocarbon. Unsaturated hydrocarbon means where carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-carbon triple bonds are there, that are called unsaturated hydrocarbon. Simply, unsaturated hydrocarbon. Unsaturated hydrocarbon. These unsaturated hydrocarbons are again two types. That is one, double bond and triple bond. A double bond general formula is CnH2n. A triple bond general formula is CnH2n-2. For example, here CnH2n. Now, first CnH2n. Simply, if n equal to 2, if here n equal to 2, you get CH2 double bond CH2. This is ethene. Ethene react to chlorine in the presence of sunlight. This double bond is converted to single bond. After converting single bond, these two chlorine migrate both the carbon side. Simply this one. Here already carbon is there. Take one carbon and second carbon. Here two chlorine migrates both the carbon side. Simply this chlorine and this one chlorine. And each carbon equal to 4 valency. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Simply its formula is CH2Cl and CH2Cl. Its name is 1,2 dichloro. 1,2 dichloroethane. 1,2 dichloroethane. The same time, next one, CnH2n-2. CnH2n-2. In this one, if n equal to 2, if n equal to 2, acetyl is formed. Simply, that is CH, that react to chlorine. This one react to chlorine means a double bond is converted to single bond. After converting single bond, the two chlorine migrate both the carbon side. A triple bond is migrated to double bond. After converting double bond, C double bond C. These two chlorine migrate both the carbon side. Simply, this one chlorine and this one chlorine. Each carbon equal to how many valency? Basically 4. That's it. 1, 2, 3, here 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Its name is 1,2 dichloro. Its name is 1,2 dichloroethene. 1,2 dichloroethene. Again, that 1,2 dichloroethene. CH. Double bond. CH. Again, react to chlorine in the presence of sunlight to get. A triple bond is converted to double bond. After converting double bond, these two chlorine migrate both the carbon side. A double bond is converted to single bond. After converting single bond, these two chlorine migrate both the carbon side. Simply like this one. C. Single bond C. Here already chlorine. Here also already chlorine is there. this chlorine migrate to both the carbon side, fluorine, chlorine. Each carbon equal to how many valency? 4. That's why 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Its name is 1, 1, 2, 2, tetrachloro. Tetrachloroethane. 1, 2, tetrachloroethane. This is hydrocarbon. This hydrocarbon nothing but how many types today? The first one saturated hydrocarbon, second one unsaturated hydrocarbon. Saturated hydrocarbon, what is the definition? If carbon-carbon single bond is there, that are called saturated hydrocarbon. Unsaturated hydrocarbon means carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-carbon triple bonds are there, that is unsaturated hydrocarbon. Saturated hydrocarbon, the best example is alkane. That alkane generated from the CH4. This CH4 react to chlorine in the presence of sunlight to get monochloromethane. That monochloromethane react to chlorine to get dichloromethane. Dichloromethane react to chlorine to get trichloromethane, is nothing but chloroform. Chloroform react chlorine to get carbon tetrachloride. That all equations are in the presence of sunlight. The next one, unsaturated hydrocarbon. That unsaturated hydrocarbon, its definition is when carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bonds, simply multiple bonds are takes place, that are called unsaturated hydrocarbon. That means simply ethane react chlorine to get 1,2 dichloroethane. Acetylene react chlorine to get 1,2 dichloroethane. Again, that 1,2 dichloroethane react chlorine to get 1,2 tetrachloroethane. This is chemical properties of chlorine. First one water, second one hydrogen, third one alkali, fourth one metal, fifth one hydrocarbon, and sixth one is react to benzene. And sixth one react to benzene. Here react to benzene means when chlorine reacts to benzene to get chlorobenzene. When chlorine reacts to benzene to get chlorobenzene. Simply, chlorine react to benzene means C6H6 to get C6H5Cl+HCl. Simply, this formula is also written as when benzene react to chlorine to get chlorobenzene. Its formula, this one plus HCl. The next one, seventh one, react to carbon monoxide. React to carbon monoxide. Here, chlorine react to carbon monoxide to get COCl. To get COCl, carbonyl compound, is nothing but coxene. And react to nitrogen monoxide. Here, nitrogen monoxide react to chlorine, get a 2 moles to get nitrosyl chloride. To get nitrosyl chloride. Ninth one, react to sulfur monoxide. Here, sulfur monoxide react to chlorine to get sulfonyl compound. To get sulfonyl compound. The last one is react to ammonia. React to ammonia. These react to ammonia are basically two types. That is one, here 8 moles of ammonia. 8 moles of ammonia. That react to 3 moles of chlorine to get NH4Cl. Simply, 6 moles of NH4Cl, 6 moles of NH4Cl plus N2. 6 moles of NH4Cl plus N2. The last one, 4 moles of NH3. 4 moles of NH3, again 3 moles of chlorine. 3 moles of chlorine to get NCl3 plus 6 HCl, NCl3 plus 6 HCl. So this is chemistry of chlorine. Now, so in these 7th group elements, we already discussed electronic configuration, oxidation state, interhalogen compound, oxy acids of chlorine, and then oxides of chlorine. After that oxides of chlorine, today topic, what are the chemical reactivities? These chemical reactivities are 4 types: react to water, react to alkalis, react to hydrogen, and react to metals. These hydrogens are 4 types. Fluorine is formed in the dark condition, chlorine is formed in the slow, in the fast, in sunlight, bromine is formed in the room temperature, and iodine is formed in the catalyst. After that, chemistry of fluorine. This chemistry of fluorine, it was introduced by Chile. It was introduced by Chile. This chlorine is a greenish color compound. Chlorine is a greenish color compound. Methods of preparation of chlorine, which can be react to MnO2 and react to KNO4 and react to O2. So that means hydrochloric acid react to MnO2 to get MnCl2H2O+Cl. Then hydrochloric acid react to KNO4 to get MnCl2K2MnO4Cl2+H2O. We already discussed. The next one, chemical properties of chlorine. These are again following types. They react to water. Chlorine react to water to get HCl and HOCl. That HOCl is thermally dissociate to get incandescent oxygen. That's why this chlorine is a good bleaching agent. The next one, after that, react to alkalis. Chlorine react to alkalis to get NaCl, NaOCl+H2O. These are two conditions. One is dilute condition and second one is concentrated condition. In the dilute condition, NaCl and NOCl is formed. In the concentrated condition, NaCl and NaCl2 is formed. After that, react to hydrogen. Next, metal. Metal react to chlorine to get metal chloride. Hydrocarbon, saturated, unsaturated. Saturated means carbon-carbon single bond. Methane react to chlorine to get monochloromethane. Monochloromethane react to chlorine to get dichloromethane. Dichloromethane react to chlorine to get trichloromethane. Is nothing but chloroform. Chloroform react to chlorine to get carbon tetrachloride. These all equations are in the presence of sunlight. The next one, second one, unsaturated. Means, what is the definition of unsaturated hydrocarbon? When carbon-carbon single bond, when carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-carbon triple bonds are tasteless, are called unsaturated hydrocarbon. Simply, ethane react chlorine to get one carbon to dichloroethane. That means, when double bond is converted to single bond, after converting single bond, the two chlorine migrate to both the carbon side. Acetyl react chlorine to get 1, 2 dichloroethane and finally 1, 2 tetrachloroethane. Here benzene react chlorine to get chlorobenzene. Carbon monoxide react to chlorine to get carbonyl chloride. And nitrogen monoxide react chlorine to get nitrosyl chloride. Sulfur monoxide react chlorine to get sulfonyl chloride. Ammonia. Ammonia react chlorine to get NH4Cl and NH3. So this is chemistry of chlorine. So, the remaining topic we'll discuss on next class. So, this is 7th group element. Next to one more chapter, one more topic is there in this chapter. So, this topic we discuss on maximum 1 or 2 class. One more important thing, ma'am. In the first day we discuss noble gas element, 0 group elements. So, due to some technical problem, we discuss that the topic after 3-4 days. The chapter name is noble gas elements. Okay.